गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर सब्जेक्ट इज डिज़ाइन ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट स्ट्रक्चर 1। आवर टूडेज टॉपिक इज डिज़ाइन ऑफ स्टेयर केस बाय वर्किंग स्ट्रेस मेथड। इन लास्ट लेक्चर न्यूमेरिकल पार्ट 2 वी सॉल्व वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ स्टेयर केस, टाइप ऑफ स्टेयर केस इज डॉगलेट स्टेयर केस। इन टूडेज लेक्चर ऑल्सो वी हैव टू सॉल्व वन अनादर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ डॉगलेट स्टेयर केस। ओके, the example is design a dogleg stair for a residential building in which the vertical distance between floor to floor is 3.1 meter, means vertical distance between floor to floor is 3.1 meter. From this is a first floor, it is a second floor, this distance is a 3.1 meter and this half distance is 1.55 meter. Okay, so the space available for staircase is 2 meter into 3.2 meter, means the space available for staircase means like this. So the space available is staircase, this distance is 2 meter and this distance is a 3.2 meter. Okay, so the live load may be taken as a 2.75 kilonewton per meter square. The live load L is acting here 2.75 kilonewton meter square. Use M15 concrete, the grade of concrete is M15 and Fe 250 steel, means the grade of steel is 250 and the grade of concrete is M15. Solution: staircase hall size, here size of the staircase is given 2 meter by 3.20 meter. Here the size of hall is given, floor to floor height also given. The floor to floor height is 1 meter, so the height is 3.10 meter. Now the live load staircase is given 2.75 kilonewton per meter square, grade of concrete is M15, so use M15 and Fe 250, the steel grade is given Fe 250. So now table number 21, permissible stresses in concrete, means we have to find here sigma CBC. The sigma CBC value for grade of concrete, our grade of concrete is M15. So for M15, the grade is the bending permissible stresses in concrete is 5. So take here 5 newton per mm square. So for Fe 250, means grade of steel is Fe 250. So table number permissible stresses in steel, here mild steel is given. So mild steel means 250, for 250 over 20 mm, here 130, sigma st is 130, so consider is 130. Okay, now first step, calculation of design constant. By working stress method, we have to solving this dogleg staircase. So first step, calculation of design constant. Here we have to find four design constant. First is a modular ratio. So modular ratio is equals to M. The formula to calculate modular ratio is M is equals to 280 divided by 3 into sigma CBC. 280 divided by 3 into sigma CBC is 5. For the grade of concrete is M15, so for M15 sigma CBC is 5, so the answer is 18.66. okay, second we have to find here K, neutral axis depth factor. K we have to find here, K, so K is equals to M into sigma CBC divided by M into sigma CBC plus sigma ST. So in first step we find here modular ratio is 18.66. so 18.66 for M15 grade, the sigma CBC is 5 divided by modular ratio is 18.66 into sigma CBC is 5, and sigma ST is 130. Sigma ST for Fe 250, the value of sigma ST is 130. So the answer is 0.42. This answer is 0.42. So third, we have to calculate here lever arm J. Lever arm factor J, third design constant we have to find here. So the formula to calculate J is equals to 1 minus K by 3. 1 minus K, in second step we find here K. So value of K is 0.42 divided by 3. The answer is 0.86. So now fourth design constant is moment resisting factor Q. Formula to calculate moment resisting factor Q is equals to 1 by 2 into sigma CBC into J into K. So 1 by 2, sigma CBC means permissible stresses in concrete is 5. 5 is for M15 grade. So J is in third step, we find here J 0.86. So use 0.86 into K. The factor of K is 0.42. So 0.42. The answer of Q is 0.90. So we find here for design constant, modular ratio is 18.66. Depth of K factor is 0.42. Lever arm factor is 0.86. And moment resisting factor is 0.90. So second step we have to find here calculation dimension for the staircase. So here in hall size we already given in example 2 meter by 3.2 meter. Here size is already given. So size of staircase is given 3.20 meter and the 2 meter. 3.2 meter by 2 meter size is given. So now calculation of dimension. So we have to find here calculation of dimension. So floor to floor height is given, is already given. Floor to floor height is 3.10 meter. So height of each flight, we have to find here height of each flight. Here floor to floor height is given means this first floor, this second floor, this height is, this height is 3.10 meter. So the half, this half height is divided by 2. So it is a 1.55. height of each flight is, means height of each flight is 3.10 divided by 2 is divided into 2. So 1.55 meter, here is a 1.55 meter. Second, assume a rise. So assume rise here 155 mm. For residential building we can assume rise between 150 mm to 180 mm, and for a public building we assume 120 mm to 150 mm. So we assume here 155 mm. So now third, we have to find here number of riser required. Now we have to find here rise of step. So number of riser, rise we already calculated here, rise is 155 mm. Now number of riser means how many riser we provided here. So 155 means 1.55 divided by 0.15 means 1550 mm divided by 155 mm means this height of each flight divided by R. So this is a 10 in each flight, means number of rise, this rise is 10. We have to provide here a 10. It is a 10 riser. So number of tread in each flight, to calculate number of tread means this is a tread, this is a tread, this tread we have to calculate here. So number of tread is equals to number of riser minus 1. Number of riser is 10, so 10 minus 1 is 9. Okay, now assume tread is 250. So assume here ट्रेड साइज इज 250 mm, मीन्स 0.25 मीटर. ओके, सो नाउ एज्यूम अ क्लियरेंस 100 mm. वॉट इज अ क्लियरेंस? एज्यूम क्लियरेंस इज 100 mm. हियर दिस डिस्टेंस इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ क्लियरेंस. इट इज अ 0.10 मीटर, मीन्स डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू विड्थ, दिस फर्स्ट विड्थ एंड दिस सेकंड विड्थ, दिस डिस्टेंस इज कॉल्ड एज अ क्लियरेंस. ओके, सो वी कंसिडर हियर 100 mm, मीन्स 0.1 मीटर. सो नाउ 7 इज अ विड्थ ऑफ स्टेयर. विड्थ ऑफ स्टेयर वी हैव टू फाइंड हियर. विड्थ ऑफ स्टेयर इफ वी एज्यूम वी हैव टू फाइंड हियर विड्थ, सो वी ऑलरेडी गिवन द साइज ऑफ हॉल इज 3.2 मीटर बाय 2 मीटर. हियर यू कैन कंसिडर द इज गिवन 2 मीटर बाय 3.2 मीटर. सो द इज गिवन 2 मीटर. सो 2 माइनस क्लियरेंस मीन्स दिस 2 माइनस क्लियरेंस 0.10. सो 2 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 फॉर ईच वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड हियर ईच दिस टू दिस डिस्टेंस इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ 0.95 मीटर. सो दिस डिस्टेंस इज 0.95 मीटर. 2 माइनस 0.1 दैट इज 1.9 एंड 1.9 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 दैट इज अ 0.95 मीटर. 0.95 मीटर. ओके, सो विड्थ ऑफ लैंडिंग, ईच लैंडिंग विड्थ इज 0.95 मीटर. इट इज अ सेम एज अ विड्थ ऑफ स्टेयर इज 0.95 मीटर एंड द लैंडिंग ऑल्सो 0.95 मीटर. सो गोइंग स्पेस ऑक्युपाइड बाय अ ट्रेड. फॉर्मुला टू कैलक्युलेट ट्रेड इज 3.2. हियर द डिस्टेंस इज 3.2. 3.2 माइनस दिज 0.95. 3 माइनस 0.95 इज 2.25. सो दिस डिस्टेंस इज 2.25. ओके, सो हियर वी कैलक्युलेटेड द राइज ऑफ अवर स्टेयर केस इज 155. दिस डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू स्टेयर मीन्स ट्रेड इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ ट्रेड. दिस ट्रेड इज 250 mm. आफ्टर दैट दिस लैंडिंग इज 0.9095 मीटर. दिस ऑल्सो विड्थ ऑफ स्टेयर इज 0.95 मीटर. हियर वी कैलक्युलेटेड. सो नाउ इफेक्टिव डेप्थ वी हैव टू कैलक्युलेट. हियर इफेक्टिव डेप्थ, इफेक्टिव डेप्थ इज 0.95 प्लस 2.25 प्लस 0.23. द एडिशन ऑफ दिस 3, 2.25, 0.95 एंड 0.23, 0.95, 2.25 एंड 0.23, द एडिशन ऑफ दिस 3 इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ 3.43. मीन्स यल इज कैलक्युलेटेड 3.43 मीटर. सो नाउ थर्ड नेक्स्ट स्टेप वी हैव टू फाइंड हियर कैलक्युलेशन ऑफ लोडिंग मीन्स W. मीन्स वी हैव टू फाइंड हियर लोड ऑफ स्टेयर केस. सो टू कैलक्युलेट द लोड, कैलक्युलेशन ऑफ लोडिंग, बिफोर दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड हियर अ डेप्थ ऑफ वेस्ट स्लैब. सो थिकनेस ऑफ वेस्ट स्लैब इज फॉर्मूला टू कैलक्युलेट द थिकनेस ऑफ वेस्ट स्लैब इज L बाय 20 टू L बाय 25. सो L इफेक्टिव वी ऑलरेडी कैलक्युलेटेड हियर 3.43. सो 3.43 डिवाइडेड बाय 20 टू 3.43 डिवाइडेड बाय 25. सो 1.50 टू 137. सो वी कंसिडर वन बिटवीन दिस टू. सो वी कंसिडर बिटवीन दिस टू 137 एंड 171. वी कंसिडर हियर 150. सो कवर इज 25. सो 150 वी एज्यूम हियर डी इज 150 एंड कवर इज 25. सो हाउ वी कैलक्युलेटेड स्मॉल डी? स्मॉल डी इज इक्वल्स टू डी माइनस सी. कवर इज 25 एंड कैपिटल डी इज 150. सो दिस वैल्यू इज कॉल्ड एज अ 125. सो कंसिडर अ 1 मीटर विड्थ ऑफ लाइट. लाइव लोड इज गिवन 2.75 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. फ्लोर फिनिश इज गिवन 1 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. वेट ऑफ स्टेप इज we can calculate here weight of step 1 by 2 into r into 25. So the answer is 1 by 2 into rise is 0.155 into 25, so 1.94 kilonewton meter. It's answer of weight of one step. So now we have to calculate it here, self weight. We have to find here self weight of slab. We have to find here self weight of slab. So self weight of slab is 25 into t into under root of r square plus t square divided by t. It is a formula to calculate self weight. So here d we consider here 150, so d is 0.15. R is 0.155, R is 155, so 0.15, T is 250 and T is 250, so calculate here, the answer is 4.41. So total weight of load on staircase, that is 2.75 plus 3.75 plus 1.94 plus 4.41, the total is 10.10, means the load on staircase W is 10.10 kilonewton meter. Okay, so now we have to find here calculation of maximum bending moment. We have to find here maximum bending moment. So to calculate maximum bending moment, M is equals to WL square by 2. To calculate simply supported moment, formula is WL square by 8. Load is W is 10.10. L effective we find here 3.43. So 3.43 square by 8. M is 14.85 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. So now check for depth. Our depth is okay or not, we have to check here. So by equating maximum bending moment and resisting moment, so formula is M is equals to QBD square. M is 14.85 into 10 to the power 6. Q design constant, moment resisting factor, design is 0.90. We find here moment resisting factor. Moment resisting factor Q is find here 0.90. So moment resisting factor is 0.90. So width we consider here, consider 1 meter width, so 1000 mm into d square, so d required is 128.45. we required here small d is 128.45 and we consider here 125, so it is not safe because d provided it is not more, d provided we provided is 25, so it is not greater. So this is a 128 and this is a 125, it is not okay. So we have to provide a increasing depth. So increase a depth, up to which we increase a depth here 171 to 137. So we increase the depth between it. So D we consider because we have to increase up, more than 128. So we consider here small d is 130 and capital D is 155. So if this is a 128.45 and we provided is 130, so it is okay. So after if we have to use a depth, so use this, okay, small d is 130 and capital D is 155. If in any calculation the depth is our assumption depth is failed, then increase this depth. Okay, so next calculation of mean steel. We have to calculate it here mean steel. AST is equals to M divided by sigma st into j into d. M is 14.85 into 10 to the power 6. Here we find m is 14.85 into 10 to the power 6. So 14.85 into 10 to the power 6, sigma st is 130. For Fe 250, this is 130. J is Liveran factor 0.86, and D, we assume here D is 130 depth. So D is 130. AST is 1021.74 mm square, and AST minimum. If the grade of steel is given, Fe 250, so for Fe 250 formula is 0.15 of AG, means 0.15 into B into D. If Fe 415 is given, then for steel grade Fe 415 or 500, for this formula is 0.12% of AG. But our steel grade is Fe 250, so for Fe 250 the formula is 0.15 into B into D. So 0.15, B is 1000, means 1 meter, so 1000, and capital D is 155. Here we increasing depth, so 155, so divided by 100 percentage. So AST minimum is 232.50 mm, provided AST is 1021.74 mm square. From these 232.50 and 1021 is greater, so we provided 1021.74. assume diameter of bar is 10 mm. Spacing, first step here to calculate spacing is 1000 pi by 4 into D square, bar square, divided by AST. 1000 into pi by 4, pi is 3.14, divided by 4. The diameter is 10 square, so AST we provided here, provided AST is 1021.74. so the answer is 76.87 mm. Second criteria to calculate spacing is 3 into d means small d, so 3 into d is 130, so this answer is 390. And third criteria is is equals to 300. So use whichever is less from these three. 1, 2, 3. From these three, first is 76.87, 390, and 300. Use whichever is less from these three. 76.87 is less. So assume here 76, 75. So provider here we assume diameter of bar is 10 mm. So provider 10 mm diameter of bar. About the spacing, 75 mm center to center as a main steel. Okay, so now the calculation of distribution steel ASTD. We have to calculate here ASTD, distribution steel. So provided distribution steel, that is AST minimum. So we already here find AST minimum. AST minimum is 232.50. So 232.50 mm. Assume diameter of bar for distribution steel. Assume diameter of bar is 8 mm. So to calculate spacing, formula is 1000 into pi by 4 into D square divided by AST. So 1000 into pi by 4 into D 8 square. The diameter of bar is 8 square. So ASTD, distribution area of distribution steel, is 232.50. So answer is 216.19. second criteria is 5d, 5 into 130, depth is 130, so consider here 650. Okay, third is criteria, s is 450. So use whichever is less from these three. 1, 2, this first, this second, and this third. From these three, 216.19 is less, so assume here 200 mm. So provider 8 mm bar, we consider here 8 mm diameter, about 200 mm center to center spacing as a distribution steel. Okay, so next is development length. We have to find here a development length for a staircase. To formula to calculate development length is diameter of bar is 10, sigma st is phi is 10, sigma st is 130 divided by फोर इंटू टाउ बी सी. सो द आंसर इज 0.8 इंटू दिस कंसिडर फॉर ग्रेड ऑफ स्टील एंड कॉन्क्रीट. सो दिस आंसर इज 0.8 इंटू 1.6. सो एल डी इज 253.91. ओके सो डेवलपमेंट लेंथ इज 253.91. ओके सो आफ्टर कैलक्युलेशन ऑफ ऑल स्टेप वी हैव टू ड्रॉ हियर वन डायग्राम ऑफ द स्टेयरकेस. सो दिस फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस इट इज कॉल्ड एज एल डी डेवलपमेंट लेंथ एंड वी प्रोवाइडेड हियर डेवलपमेंट लेंथ इज 253.91. सो कंसिडर हियर 250 mm. ओके सो राइज वी कंसिडर हियर 155 mm. ट्रेड इज 250. सो ट्रेड ही इट इज अ ट्रेड एंड इट इज अ राइज. सो दिस पोर्शन इज कॉल्ड एज अ लैंडिंग. अवर लैंडिंग इज 0.95 meter. ओके सो मेन बार वी प्रोवाइडेड मेन बार द डायमीटर ऑफ मेन बार इज 10 mm एंड द स्पेसिंग इज 75 mm सेंटर टू सेंटर. डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन स्टील वी प्रोवाइडेड 8 mm बार एंड 200 mm सेंटर टू सेंटर. फ्रॉम अप टू दिस डिस्टेंस इज 2.25 meter. वी ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेटेड एंड दिस लैंडिंग डिस्टेंस इज 0.95 एंड वॉल इज 0.23 meter. ओके सो वी ड्रॉ हियर sections of the staircase, how many bar we provided here, spacing of the bar, diameters of the bar and section we draw here. Okay, so in this today's lecture we solved one numerical of dogleg staircase. Anyone having doubt in today's lecture, you can put your question in chat box. Okay, thank